I think let's make Christmas special. It should be special. First of all, it's the birthday of Jesus Christ, God's Son. God coming to this earth in the form of a man for the purpose of saving mankind from sin. And that is a special day. We should treat that day special.
This Christmas might look really different for a lot of people. A lot different maybe from last year. Can you speak to that in any way?
Well, let me just, something my mother taught me, all of us, not just me, but all of us children growing up, to help others. And my mother and father had a checking account, and they called it the help fund. And it was just, if daddy got an honorarium for speaking somewhere or something, they put it in that help fund. And they would look for people in the community that needed help. Maybe their house burned down, or maybe they'd lost their job and people were out of work and Christmas was coming. And they knew that a few $100 here or there could make a big difference in a person's Christmas. They looked around for people to help. And now they did that quietly. They didn't make a big deal about it. They didn't advertise it. They just quietly, my entire life, were helping people in the community, local people. And so their faith was real. Yeah. And when we come to Christmas, because of the commercialism and all the other stuff, it'd be very easy to lose sight. My mother and father believed the scriptures cover to cover. We worshiped the King at Christmas, but quietly they lived out what they believed by just helping other people in time of need.
I could have almost thought I grew up in some kind of a secular environment, because at some point, you know, we had the cookies and the milk for Santa Claus and the presents. And I mean, it was like that in our home also. And the idea that there can be balance to the story of Christmas, and that sure, for the most part, people have secularized and they have said the terms Xmas, and there are, you know, I still have a traditional streak in my inside of me that if we do a Christmas card, it has to have a nativity. I mean, it just, there's something about it that, you know, it would feel like sin to me if our Christmas card didn't have a, you know, a star and the whole manger and the whole thing and the camel and the wise men. But there is also the idea that there can be fun, and that's what you're experiencing. That's what you're telling us. You're giving us a look at the balance of that.
Well, my mother and father are buried in Charlotte at the Billy Graham Library. And at Christmas, we take that fun to the library, because I know that's exactly what my mother would want. And so we decorate the library, not with Santa Claus, but just with the holly and all the lights. And it's a place to go and spend Christmas and have a traditional kind of a Christmas meal and just take the family on a horse ride through the property. So we still, I think let's make Christmas special. It should be special. First of all, it's the birthday of Jesus Christ, God's Son. God coming to this earth in the form of a man for the purpose of saving mankind from sin. And that is a special day. We should treat that day special. Not only should we be reverent, but there's no reason why we can't be joyous, because we should be happy that the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords has come to this earth to save sinners, and I'm one of them. I'm just thank God that when I was young, I was 22, when I accepted Christ as my Savior. I had run from God. I had rebelled against God. I didn't want him in my life. I wanted to play. I wanted to party. It wasn't that I didn't believe. I did, but I just didn't want God running my life.
Wow.
I wanted to run my own life. And I finally just got to the point where I was sick and tired of just being sick and tired. And I got on my knees one night and I said, God, I've sinned and I'm sorry. Forgive me. If you can just take the broken pieces of my life and put it together, you can have it. And when I prayed that prayer, I meant it. And he took my life, the broken piece of my life, and he began to put it together. And I've made many mistakes in life, and I've sinned many times in life, but I just get on my knees and confess it and ask for his forgiveness and get back up and go.
Mm. Beautiful.